Ayala Corporation boss Fernando Zobel de Ayala goes on a temporary medical leave. The company told the stock exchange the tycoon has taken a leave of absence as its president, CEO, and vice chairman of the board. He has also stepped down as member of the company's executive and finance committees. No other details regarding his medical leave were disclosed. Cesar Kunsing will assume Ayala's management duties as acting president, CEO, and member of the executive committee. Delfin Lazaro was also elected vice chairman of the executive committee. The Philippines and China officially restart talks on transportation projects. Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista and Chinese Ambassador Wang Shilian discussed the resumption of talks for major China-funded railway projects like the PNR South Long Haul Project, the Subic-Clark Railway, and the Mindanao Railway. The two also talked about maritime cooperation projects. Secretary Bautista adds, the Philippines is also eyeing partnerships with other countries like Japan.
They will see to it that the contractors that will work will provide or will give us very competitive rates so that the overall cost of constructing the projects will be cheaper. Even the interest rate may be a little bit higher. Because he said the interest rate is a very small portion of the total project. We're not limiting our options to China. No? We can also consider working with Japan and JICA.
Meanwhile, the Public Works Department said South Korea is interested in funding more infrastructure projects of the Philippine government. So far, there are three ongoing projects under South Korea's Economic Development Cooperation Fund in Northern Samar, Northern Mindanao, and Central Luzon. A look now at this week's oil price movements. Diesel prices will see the biggest rollback of 1 peso and 5 centavos per liter Tuesday, while a liter of kerosene will be 45 centavos cheaper. Gasoline prices will also be slashed by 10 centavos per liter. This will be the sixth straight rollback for oil prices as the global economy reels from recession fears due to high inflation. More Filipinos fell below the poverty line last year. In its latest report, the Philippine Statistics Authority says the poverty incidence has risen to 18.1% in 2021, which is equivalent to 19.9 million poor Filipinos. That figure is higher than the 16.7% poverty incidence in the last survey held in 2018. Socioeconomic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says it's a reflection of the impact of mobility restrictions on wages and jobs. He is confident the Marcos administration can reduce the poverty incidence this year until the end of his term.
Given the opening up of the economy, greater opening up of the economy in 2022, more the reduction in the unemployment numbers and underemployment numbers in 2022, it's likely that the poverty incidence would be lower despite the uptick in the inflation. Even more so as we try to reduce the burden of that high prices on the poor by targeting our cash transfers programs or 4-piece program to the most deserving members of our population.